What is up? Hello, witches! Welcome to Jaded Raven Witchery. I'm so glad you guys are here. My name is Jade, and I'm here to discuss earth magic and witchcraft and all sorts of fun stuff like that. So, join me and let's talk about some things, okay? I want to talk about some bare bones basics, earth magic or spell work, that you can do immediately. You don't need a scent. You don't need to buy anything fancy or special, okay? The bare basics. I do want to also touch on ethics, okay? Ethics is something important. There's a lot of, you're gonna hear a lot of different things, okay? You're gonna hear a lot of white light, good pure energy stuff, and that is great. That is fantastic. But all things have a duality to them. All things have a dual nature. Nothing is either all good or all bad, okay? And I think it's important to keep in mind that, you know, witchcraft and earth magic is no different. All things have both positive and negative effects. And really, it's just about using your discretion, your best judgment, and, you know, doing things with a good intention. Do what you will, okay? That is how I see it. You know, use your best judgment. But I am not against working with darker energies, and that is just who I am, bottom line. Without me rambling any further, let's get into some real basic stuff. I do want to talk about, I want to talk about grimoires really quick. As you're researching witchcraft and all sorts of magic information, you're going to probably want to take some notes because there's so many different traditions, there's so many different ideas that you're gonna want to make sure on some level you're kind of keeping your information organized and in a way that makes sense to you. This was not my first grimoire. This is a big fancy one that I have put together in more recent years. This was my very first one. Okay, it's just a blank book from Barnes & Noble that I used for years and years. And I think it's really good to have one like that because you're gonna later in life, if you do stay on this path, sort through the information and probably sift through it and with different eyes later in life, possibly, okay? What can you do right now to start practicing witchcraft? There are some things you're gonna wanna practice, okay? One is your imagination and visualizations, okay? You're gonna wanna be able to very clearly, sorry, my nose is so itchy. You're gonna wanna be able to very clearly picture and envision things in your mind, all right? And you're going to want to get so good at this that you literally, you know, what do you see? What do you hear in these visualizations that are going on in your mind? What can you smell, feel, touch, taste, right? That's going to be highly effective. It's, you know, there are three things you can do to start working manifestations and magic and bringing things into you very quickly. And one that is imagination and visualization, right? We just went over. The clearer, the better, right? Number two is also the written word. Writing these manifestations, these dreams, these goals, aspirations, whatever it is, writing it out. There's something very powerful about the written word, okay? And doing this, it's literally doing something, setting an intention, visualizing it, writing it out. And then the third thing that I think is really important is verbalizing it, saying it to the universe, right? So I do strongly believe if you are doing these three things, you can start manifestation and start practicing these things and working with energies, working your powers immediately. So there are a lot of different traditions and a lot of different beliefs when it comes to all different forms of paganistic beliefs. There are so many different types of magical work. You know, there's so many different ideas out there, okay? But it is generally agreed upon by quite a few. I have noticed that there are certain things that are important. Knowledge. Okay, doing the proper research, learning, taking the time to learn correctly, that's a huge thing, okay? Your will is another. Being persistent, right? Using, and you can use this meditation and visualizations to work your will. Your will is your intent, what you are intending to have happen, right? And if, you know, that is something that you're wielding, that is something that has power. Another thing is having faith in yourself and your own abilities, right? You have to have just an absolute faith in yourself, and that you have this power, that and everybody has it, and you have to know that this is going to work. And so be cautious what you're doing. Have faith in yourself. This does work, and you should know that. It might not come that easily for everyone. Some have to work harder than others, right? But I'm sure that a lot of you out there have maybe noticed that you have wished so hard for something that it happened, or you thought so much about something that it came to you. In some weird, strange, synchronistic kind of way, I mean, it's not a coincidence. You're manifesting, all right? So, the last thing is secrecy, okay? Being secretive, whether you're working in a group or alone, it's important. You don't need to, if you're working as a group, that stays within the group. You know, if you're working by yourself, you do not need to tell everybody what you're manifesting or what kind of spell we're crafting. Don't do that. Okay? Less is more. You're going to want to be able to meditate, okay? And I have heard a lot of people they don't understand meditation, they're not sure what it's supposed to be. They have trouble emptying their mind. But meditation is simply contemplating visualizations and concentrating on it. That is literally like doing the visualizations, and that's got to do with your will, right? What you're intending to have happen. That's all that meditation really is. So instead of trying to empty your mind and think of nothing, you can do these visualizations while meditating. It is a form of meditation. So you can, there's a couple techniques I'm going to talk about. One is earthing or grounding your energy. Imagining a connection between you and the earth. The ideal place to do this is obviously outside, right? Directly on the earth if possible. But if not, if that is not possible, then from your own home is fine. As realistic as possible when you're visualizing yourself and these energies, right? So in your place, wherever you are, really ground to the earth in real time. So to earth or ground your energy and connect and exchange your energy with the earth, you're going to want to preferably be sitting outside directly in contact with the earth. If you can't be, that's okay. You're still going to visualize light, right? Light and good positive energy coming down through the center of your being, coming out of you. It's your energy, right? And you're going to picture this coming down out of your feet, the bottoms of your feet, or your bottom, your butt, growing down into the earth, growing as roots do. And you want to feel these energetic roots of yours deep into the earth. You want to feel that cold dirt. What does it feel like? What does it smell like with your energy? So you can envision this, and then you envision exchanging your energy with the earth's energy. And exchange, you can visualize energy coming from the earth as well, and doing this whole exchange of these energies, maybe exchanging. So now you've got the connection. You can start it with a bright white light. Now you can envision, excess energy or different colored energies as, leaving your energy flow and going into the earth, and instead having earthier energies come up and really ground your energy. It's really, really good for you. Okay, this is important to do both before and after magical practices, before and after divination. Another technique that's important is centering yourself, right? They say in like yoga and meditation to like find your center. That's like the core of your being, right? Solar plexus chakra or the heart chakra or somewhere in between, right, would be your center. Your center of gravity as well would be somewhere in the middle of your body. But finding your center just simply means you're being like balanced in the center of your energy, right? As you practice this, You know, you just want to visualize your energy centering in the middle, right? Coming together, and you can feel that central point of yourself. Another thing we can do is connect, right? Connect with the earth energy and earthing or grounding. You can connect with your higher self. You can connect with spirit. You can just envision your energy connecting to higher energies, right? Source, the Akashic records, however you want to view it. So you can visualize this connection. And then you can also shield your energy, right? The white bubble of light, or you can envision anything you want. Okay, shielding and protecting your energy. So those are four different, like, real basic techniques that you can practice. One thing that I like to do is I like to kind of get into this state where I'm kind of doing all three. So I first will visualize this energy coming down out of me and growing into the earth, and I'm doing the earthing or grounding and exchanging my energy with the earth, right? So I picture that going down into the earth, and then I'm also centering myself, or so I bring this energy down and I imagine this energy exchange, and then I'm bringing the energy back up, right, to my higher self, and then I'm centering. So ground, higher self, center, you know, and I'm picturing this energetic energy coming through me. And it's coming up and almost doing like a figure eight, right? And so I will sit and do this for maybe 10, 15 minutes. And it's very calming. It's very, you feel very centered and grounded and very in tune with your higher self by the time you are done doing this for a little while. I do want to make a note about how I use the term grimoire. To me, a grimoire is your notes that you will take, whereas your book of shadows is more your actual rituals and spell work. So that is the difference for me. Other people will use the words interchangeably or vice versa. For me, the grimoires are my notes that I've collected from places, while my books of shadows are my rituals and my spells. And do you want to make a couple book recommendations for people who are interested? Mastering Witchcraft, A Practical Guide for Witches, Warlocks, and Covens by Paul Huson. Amazing book. Had this since I was like 17, 18 years old. It's been great. This is by Laura Tempest Zakroff, and I did kind of touch on this book and reviewed a deck of her cards, a witchcraft deck that she put out recently. I will link that probably in the description box below if you want to check that out. This is an amazing book. She is a modern traditional witch. And she really, really puts things in a really nice perspective. Amazing book. Another one that I've loved for a really long time is Witchcraft Theory and Practice by Lee DeAngelis. This is another amazing one I've had for a really long time. Highly, highly recommend any of these three books if you are just starting off and a little confused. Another good option if you don't have a ton of time, let's say you have small children or you work a lot and you don't have a ton of time for this much research and note-taking. This is Grimoire of the Green Witch by Anne Moura. This is a complete, it says Grimoire for the Green Witch, a complete book of shadows. This is technically kind of like a grimoire and book of shadows rolled into one. If you are interested in like green witchcraft, and it's actually based on a lot of Celtic and Druid type traditions, this is a great option. It's kind of got everything in here, and you can follow along and just change certain things to suit your style. I do highly recommend that if you don't have time, but it is always the preference that you do your own work, do your own research. Something about writing things out, especially even if with a like pen and ink, like actual pen and ink, like something about that is amazing and magical, and something absolutely special happens. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, and yeah, make sure you're practicing your visualizations, writing out your intentions, and also speaking them aloud to the universe. It's a very powerful form of magic and manifestation. And it's a great way to kind of start exercising your energies and getting comfortable with how to ground and center yourself and how to connect with your higher self and kind of feel these energies, right? And start working with visualizations and your will And yeah, remember to keep things secret. And that kind of recaps everything I talked about. But this is the bare bones basics I wanted to cover, where you can get started and without a penny to your name, start literally making things happen for yourself. Okay? So thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe for more. And don't forget to check me out on Star, Moon, and Sun Tarot, where I read for all 12 signs every week and review tarot and oracle decks as well. So yes, much love to you all, and I hope to see you guys next time. All right, bye.